Okay, guys, this is a continuation of chapter 23. Okay, we'll just start by page 187, okay? Deborah went into McKissick's office to give more blood on June 26th of 1974, 4 days before the new federal law went into effect requiring IRB approval and informed consent for all federally funded research. The new law, published in the Federal Register, 1 month earlier, applied to all subjects of risk, meaning any individual who may be exposed to the possibility of injury, including physical, psychological, or social injury, as a consequence of participation as a subject. But what constituted injury and risk was heavily debated. Numerous researchers had appealed to Hugh, asking that collection of blood and tissues be exempt from the new law. After all, doctors had been drawing blood for centuries for diagnostic testing, and aside from the pain of a needle stick, there seemed to be no risk. But Hugh did not exempt those procedures. In fact, it later clarified the law to specifically include them. McKissick's research on the Lacks family coincided with the beginning of a new era of genetic research, in which the concept of risk to patients would change completely. With the ability to identify genes from a blood sample or even a single cell, the risk of a blood draw was no longer just a minor infection or the pain of a needle stick. It was that someone could uncover your genetic information. It was about violation of privacy. Deborah met McKissick only once, when she went into Hopkins to give blood. He shook her hand and said that Henrietta had made an important contribution to science. Then Deborah bombarded him with questions. What made his mother sick? How was the part of her still living? What did that mean? What did Henrietta do for science? And did all those blood tests he was doing mean Deborah? And did all those blood tests he was doing mean Deborah was going to die young like her mother? McKissick did not explain why he was having someone draw blood from Deborah. Instead, he told her about Henrietta cells being used for polio vaccine and genetic research. He said they'd gone up in early space missions and had been used in atomic bomb testing. Deborah heard those things and imagined her mother on the moon and being blown up by bombs. She was terrified and couldn't stop wondering if the parts of her mother that were using in research could actually feel the things scientists were doing to them. When she asked McKissick to explain more about the cells, he gave her a book he edited called Medical Genetics, which would become one of the most important textbooks in the field. He said it would tell her everything she needed to know, then autographed inside from cover. Beneath his signature, he wrote a phone number and told her to use it for making appointments to give more blood. McKissick flipped to the second page of the introduction. There, between graphs of disease-specific infant mortality and a description of the homozygous state of Gerodian inborn errors, was the photograph of Henrietta with her hands on her hips. He pointed to the paragraph that mentioned her. Parenthetically, medical geneticists making use of the study of cells in the place of the whole patient have cashed in on a reservoir of morphologic, biochemical, and other information in cell biology, derived in no small part from study of the famous cell line culture from the patient picture on this page, Henrietta Lacks. The book was filled with complicated sentences explaining Henrietta cells by saying, "Its anatypical histology may correlate with the unusually malignant behavior of the carcinoma, and something about the correlate of the tumor singularity." Reading magazines took Deborah a long time, because she had to stop often to look up words in their dictionary. Now she sat in the clinic, gripping McKissick's book, not even trying to read the words. All she could think was that she'd never seen the photograph of her mother before. What happened to her to make her end up in there? She wondered. How did he get that picture? They swore he'd never given it to McKissick or any of Henrietta's doctors. Deborah's brothers swore that they hadn't it either. The only thing they could figure was that maybe Howard Jones had asked Henrietta for a picture, then stuck it in her medical record. But as far as they knew, no one had ever asked permission to publish it. When I talked to McKissick several years before his death in 2008, He was 79 and still conducting research and training young scientists. He didn't recall where he had gotten the photo, but he imagined Henrietta's family must have given it to Howard Jones or another doctor at Hopkins. Though McKissick remembered the research he conducted on the Lacks family, he didn't remember meeting Deborah or giving her his book, and he said he'd never had first-hand contact with the family. He had left that up to Sue. When I talked to Susan Sue, now a director of medical genetics at the American Red Cross, she told me that working with McKissick on HeLa cells was a highlight of her career. "I am very proud," she told me. "I probably will share this paper and tell my kids this is important." But when I explained to her that the Lacks thought she was testing them for cancer, and that they were upset about scientists using the cells without their knowledge, she was shocked. "I feel very bad," she said. "People should have told them. You know, we never thought at the time they did not understand." She also told me she had a message she had hoped to give it to Lack's family when I talked with them next. "Just tell them I'm really grateful," she said. "They should be very proud of my mother or the wife. Of the mother or the wife. I think that if they are angry, probably they didn't realize how famous the cells are now in the world. It's an unfortunate thing what happened. They still should be very proud. Their mother will never die as long as the medical science is around. She will always be such a famous thing." Toward the end of our conversation, Sue mentioned that she could learn much more from testing the family's bloods today, since DNA technology had advanced so much since the 70s. Then she asked if I'd tell the Lacks family one more thing for her. "If they are willing," she said, "I wouldn't mind to go back and get some more blood." This is the end of chapter 23.